Currently, this is our forecast list. It looks okay, but it would be nice if we could show the degrees symbol for these temperature values. Using this notation is best practice. It will help the translator know how to reorder the text and the parameters so that it fits the local language. Now let's look at how we can use this method to format temperatures within our app. Within the strings.xml file, we declare the format temperature string resource. We use xlif tags to denote that this is where the decimal temperature value will go. This is followed by the Unicode character for the degrees symbol. In the utility class, in the format temperature method, we can use this string resource. Remember that in this method, we take in a temperature and the user's preference for metric or imperial. Then we return the converted temperature. We're going to modify this method so that it also returns the formatted string with the degrees symbol after the value. In order to do this, we need to pass in a context. From the context, we can get access to the string resource ID that we declared earlier. Then we pass in any additional parameters for that string template. In this case, we only have one parameter, so we pass in the temperature value. Then this fully formatted string gets returned to the caller. This method is used in the forecast list as well as on the detail page, so we also had to update the code there so that it would compile with this new parameter. And this is what the app looks like after the change. Go ahead and make the change in your code to add a string resource for displaying temperature in degrees. Check this box when you're done. And remember, use this notation going forward for when you need to format strings.